Okay guys, so I've just completed one round of this workout. So as you can see, it flows really nicely from one exercise to the next. You have 10 seconds to change. So first exercise is just a plank. So from here, lift your hips up, hold the plank. 20 seconds, hips are down, squeeze through your glutes, brace your abs nice and tight. Pull your belly button in towards your spine. And hold it here nice and tight for 20 seconds, and you can lower it down. And all you're gonna do is just swing yourself around or just roll over. Because I'm looking at you guys, keep my eye on you, okay? Then I'm gonna look up here, take my feet up and lift my head, neck and shoulders off the mat, and I'm going to twist and twist. So opposite shoulder to knee. Try not to go elbow to the knee because you'll kind of cheat. Keep the elbows wide, and that way you really have to rotate your torso side to side. You're gonna do that for 20 seconds and then lower down. And then you go back into the plank and then back into your oblique twists, okay? For the second minute. The third minute, we come down and you have sit-ups with your heels up. So toes on the ground and lift your heels. This is gonna help you activate your lower abs a lot more. So from here, just hands behind your head and you exhale up, inhale, lower down. Exhale up, inhale down. And you do that for 20 seconds. If you start to feel a tension in your neck, then you can just try taking the tongue to the roof of your mouth. It's just like a little old trick. And it just helps to relax some of those neck flexors if they start to get too much tension. And then from there, you have 10 seconds to transition. Take the feet up into tabletop, so knees are over the hips and feet are in line with the knees. Hopefully mine are. And then I'm gonna exhale, come up, hold it here, and you're gonna pulse forward, and you're gonna reach that bottom rib to the hip, reaching your fingertips long, okay? And then lower down. And then you repeat that again, sit-ups, tabletop, and then you've completed your first round, so you have a minute to recover and stretch. So you're here. I love doing a swan stretch after I've done ab workouts. It's just a nice release. So just take the feet apart and reach up. Lengthen through the abs and then lower down. So you have a minute to stretch there and you're in the perfect spot to start this again. Up into your plank, here, yep. So you're gonna do that two more times to complete a 15 minute ab workout. So keep doing this, you're gonna get some really sexy abs, defined abs. And if you keep your core really, really tight, you'll help to train them to keep them nice and flat as well, okay? So just, you know, when you do it, really think, pulling my belly button in during the plank, okay? Because we work all four sets of abdominals in a plank. So it's really, really great to do that. And you also work all the muscles along the spine. So it's really good strengthening exercise. So just really fight to do it properly, okay? And instead of just dropping, if you get tired, come down and rest, okay? Don't just drop in the lower back. It's better to rest and then come back into it if you need to. If you need to break it up into 10 seconds if you're a beginner or anything like that. And if you need a timer, you can get that, and it's a Gym Boss one I have, so that way you don't have to count, and it just makes it really easy for all your workouts. You don't have to count reps, anything. You just set the timer and it goes. So for anyone who doesn't like counting, me, this is a really great alternative. Okay, so other than that, subscribe to the channel for workouts Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and schedule yourself in to train with us. I love training with you guys. Enjoy the workout. I'm Kristen, and you're watching Perfect Fitness TV.